Let us try coding a quiz program, a piece of code that will simulate a typical quizzing-like situation. It will ask a question and then check if the answer is right or incorrect. Okay, so how does it go? Let me use the simplest possible question, which I'm sure all of you would know the answer for. When did India get its independence? So I'm talking about the year here, right? Hoping that you all know. See, input, right? You know, you all know what I'm doing here. I'm just taking the user input and assigning whatever the user inputs to the variable year here, and I convert that to integer. I hope your understanding of the previous 2 weeks is in place and you're able to see what we're doing here. And what should I do? I should simply say, if year is equal to 1947, print hip hip hooray, you're right, you got that right. So let's make it cinematic. Okay, so hip hip hooray, you got that right. As simple as that. I'll execute this. What happens? When did India get its independence? 1947. It says hip hip hooray, you got that right. I'll execute this once again. Tell me what will happen in case I did enter incorrectly. Assume I typed 1950 in place of 1947. What would happen? 1950 would simply take me out of this if loop. Of course, the if loop gets executed, but whatever is inside doesn't get executed. It comes out and does nothing. It doesn't congratulate you the way it did the last time when you got it right. Okay, so let us abuse the the user by saying, come on, don't you know even this being an Indian? Anyway, it's all for fun. No offense. So let's see what happens here. When you say, when did India get its independence? I say 1950, and I get yelled at by the computer. Come on, don't you know even this? And in case I get it right, the computer will say 1947. Hip hip hooray, you got that right. You probably are wondering, what is new in this week? We are repeating the if statement that you learned the previous week. There is an important point that's coming up. I would like to ask this question. Don't you think everybody requires a second attempt if something goes wrong? The moment if someone gets it wrong, they don't enter 1947. Of course, you can hurl and abuse and yell at the user, but then you will say, do you want to attempt once again? Right? So how do we do that? How do we do that? Let me write a code for that. Let me think how that is done. I will say, don't even know this. I'll say print. That's okay. I will let you attempt this once more. Okay? And then again I say print. When did India get its independence? And then once again I take the year, as simple as that, int input. And then again, you see, programming can get a little boring at times. If year is equal to 1947, I'll say print, you got it. Else, failed in your second attempt too. Okay, let's see what this does. When did India get its independence? The year 1940. Incorrect. Come on, don't you know even this? That's okay. I'll let you attempt this once more. When did India get its independence? I say 1947, and it congratulates. Correct? Let's start afresh once again. When did India get its independence? 1910? No, 2010. Failed in your second attempt too. Right? So now what do you do? Do you think we should write a piece of code to let that give you another attempt? So here's the deal. I would like to write a piece of code So let me remove this. I would like to write a piece of code that lets you attempt as many times as you want until you get it right. So let me write that down. I would like to write a piece of code which lets the user attempt as many times as he wants, The code will end only when it gets the right answer. Wonderful. How do we do that? So there's a difference between the word if and the word while. When do we use if? We use if to say, if that is true, then if it doesn't rain, then I'll go and play. Okay, that is different from while it doesn't rain, I will keep playing. All right, so you will get this in a minute's time. As I write a piece of code, I will not explain it. I will write and show you what this does, and you rather should tell to convince yourself what exactly this is doing. Okay, I'll say while year is not equal to 1947, I'll say you got this wrong. Enter once again. What is happening here? Let's check this out. What is happening here? Let me remove the comment just so that you see only the part of the code that is interesting. When did India get its independence? 1980? You got this wrong, enter once again. 1910? You got this wrong, enter once again. 1000? You got this wrong, enter once again. We have not got our independence, we probably will get in 2050. You got this wrong, enter once again. It's in 1947 and then it exits. Right? But it did not congratulate me, did not say hip hip hooray. So where should I include this hip hip hooray so that once I get it right, it says hip hip hooray? Where should I do that? A little bit of thinking says, before that, I believe you all understood what exactly happened here. These two lines, they keep getting executed until you get this right. Until this is true, if this is true, year is not 1947, then do this. Year is not 1947, then do this. After this, don't come down and then end the code. After this, go back and check if the year is not 1947. You make a mistake, I'll make you do this again. You make a mistake, I'll make this do once again. Make a mistake, I'll make this do once again. You get this right, then I'll not enter here, I'll end here. When I end here, I will say print. Wow, you got it right. Let's see if this works. Clearing the screen. Okay, so I'll start executing the program. When did India get its independence? 1940. Sorry. 1940. You got this wrong. 1946. You got this wrong. 1947. Wow, you got it right. So you see what this code is doing? Let's go over it once again. I'm sure most of you understood it already, but then people who are seeing programming for the first time in your life and in this course, while is not so very obvious. We want to put this on your monitor and keep staring at it for like 15-20 minutes until you get it right. First line, when did India get its independence? Second line, you take the input. And this, the next line, the fifth line here is, while the year is incorrect, you keep doing this. Tell the user that it's wrong and ask him to input once again. If he enters incorrectly, the computer will go back here. Now you may ask me, why does it go back there? Sometimes it goes ahead, sometimes it goes back. In if it goes ahead, it never goes back. But in while it goes back, why does it do it that way? That is how it is made to do. That is how programming languages are written. Whenever you put a while, whatever is inside while gets repeated until the point when the condition here is incorrect. Right? Let me just summarize that here over a comment. While works like this. Okay? You say while and you put a condition here. And then you have a tab here. I'm just commenting this. You have a tab here. Write whatever you want here. Okay? Similarly, write whatever you want here. Write whatever you want here. Sorry. Write whatever you want here. Whatever you write here will get executed. Okay? This keeps getting executed as long as the condition is true. See here, what is the condition? The condition was that year should not be 1947. The fact that the year is not 1947 became true. And that is why this got executed multiple times. Okay, a little complex there. So there is a true and a false here. The condition is true that the year was incorrect. Okay, it gets executed again and again and again until the point that you get it right. So this is like a very patient teacher. You have programmed a very patient quiz master where he will wait until you get the right answer. He doesn't get frustrated. He will not have a mood fluctuation. He will not go angry against you. Right? That's the advantage of having a machine do the job of a quiz master or for that matter any other task. There is no emotion involved here. It will not go angry. It will not get frustrated. I hope you enjoyed this piece of video. While loop is very important. It is used most often than not. In fact, as I keep saying, the for loop, while loop and if loop, you will see them in every single code more or less. Right? And this is where you make your computer repeatedly do a piece of thing again and again and again. In fact, this will do it over a million times if you get it wrong. Correct? So let us, in this week, we'll be seeing more of these looping structures. We'll see while loop, we'll see for loop, and we'll write some complicated code using these two things and solve many problems that's of interest to you. But then a word of warning, you may find it a little difficult, but as assured always, I have been assuring you from day one, it is all a matter of time, right? Yeah, so let's go to the next video now.